Good morning students, today we are going to start this chapter inverse trigonometry functions. For this chapter you should have knowledge about 1-1 and 1-2 functions that you have learned last year.
Okay, last year we learned about 1-1 and 1-2 functions. This year in the chapter relations and functions we can study 1-1 and 1-2 functions are invertible. Here we want to study about inverse trigonometry functions. Then what about trigonometry functions? Are they invertible? We know that trigonometry functions are not 1-1. That's not 1-1. Okay. If you take sin x is not 1-1. We know that values of sin x varies from minus 1 to plus 1. But after some interval, it will repeat. Again, values varies from minus 1 to 1. You can take some interval, one interval, closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. You know that sin minus pi by 2 is minus 1 and sin pi by 2 is 1. For that specific interval, closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, you will get distinct images for sin x. But if you take next values, the same values will repeat. But if you take closed interval pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, for that particular interval also, you will get distinct images for sin x. So if you take some intervals, then for that particular interval, you will get distinct images for sin x. That's same for other trigonometric functions also. So if a function is 1-1 on a part of its domain, it is said to be inversible on that part only. If a function is 1-1 on a part of its domain, it is said to be inversible on that part only. So for all trigonometry functions, we know that each trigonometry function invertible for some part only. For example, sin x is inversible in closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Again, sin x is inversible in closed interval pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. So you can take some intervals only. For that interval, that trigonometry function is inversible. Tan x is inversible in open interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. We know that tan minus pi by 2 is minus infinity, tan pi by 2 is plus infinity. So if you take this interval, open interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, you will get values from minus infinity to infinity, that all distinct values you will get. So image of tan x for this interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, that's distinct. So you can see this one. A real function f from domain of f to range of f be invertible, then you can write f inverse, that's from range of f to domain of f. Just interchange the role of domain and range here. Domain of f becomes range of f inverse. Range of f becomes domain of f inverse. Just interchange that role. So a real function f from domain of f to range of f be invertible, then f inverse we can say that's from range of f to domain of f. And you have clear idea about function, that all things we want to consider here also. Okay, then that's given by f inverse of y is equal to x if and only if y is equal to f of x. F inverse of y is equal to x if and only if y is equal to f of x. For all x belongs to domain of f and y belongs to range of f. Okay, we consider values from domain of x as domain of f as x and values from range of f as y. That's a here f inverse of y is equal to x if and only if y is equal to f of x. Okay, we can consider, we said x is one value from domain of f and y is one value from range of f. So we can consider open interval xy, ordered pair xy. We can consider ordered pair xy. This is one point on the graph of the function f. Or this ordered pair xy is one point on the graph of f. Then we can say ordered pair yx is one point on the graph of the function f inverse. If ordered pair xy is one point on the graph of the function f, then ordered pair yx is one point on the graph of the function f inverse. Okay, and we know that in lower classes you learn ordered pair yx is the reflection of the point ordered pair xy through the line y is equal to x. Ordered pair yx is the reflection of the point ordered pair xy through the line y is equal to x. So simply we can say all the points on the graph of the function f inverse is the reflection of each point on the graph of the function f through the line y is equal to x. Each point on the graph of the function f inverse is the reflection of each point of the function f through the line y is equal to x. So simply we can say that when the graph of f inverse can be obtained from the graph of f by reflecting it through the line y is equal to x. By going through the graph of sin x cos x, that all trigonometric functions, you can easily understand about that all. Okay.